huge freaking news. Want a shot at the Pro Tour? Well, Channel Fireball just announced a series of in-person competitive tournaments structured very similar to the old Magic the Gathering Grand Prix that Channel Fireball themselves also used to run. These open-entry flesh and blood tournaments feature exclusive playmats, promos, coverage, there's going to be coverage, I'm so excited, and $10,000 in prizes with top players getting Pro Tour invites. The Calling Las Vegas also features the exclusive worldwide premiere of the upcoming set Kingdoms. This is the first chance to get your hands on first edition Kingdoms cards anywhere. Will I see you in Vegas? Honestly, I'm just so excited that these are happening. They're also doing this cool thing where if you take first place in the event, you win these gold cold foil cards that are exclusive promos that you can only get through winning these events. As in, they will not exist anywhere else. It reminds me of how Magic used to do things like have these unique cards for champions of pro events. Like I said, looking all this over, and I'll link all the info in this video's description, but The Calling is really similar to just a Grand Prix from Magic. And these Pro Quest events are similar to a big PTQ from old Magic the Gathering days. I loved those. And the main event package is just entry into the main with some swag. The Go Again packages are coupons for side events and swag. This is the playmat that comes with the Fabled main event package, really cool. This one with the Go Again side event packages. Again, for more detailed information about the Flesh and Blood organized play system, I've got links in this video's description. Channel Fireball is blasting this all over social media. But I just love that we're doing exclusive promos, playmats, $10,000 in prizes, tons of side events, and an invite to the Pro Tour on the line. Oh, it's like just so exciting that they're doing this. So Flesh and Blood players won't want to miss The Calling. So will I see you in Las Vegas? I can't believe I'm actually thinking about Las Vegas again, but here we are. What I really like about these events is I feel that Flesh and Blood really started to get this reputation as this sort of game that wasn't a game at all, but for collectors. And there's a lot of cool stuff to collect, but I'm not really interested in collecting Flesh and Blood. It just doesn't do that for me. I like the gameplay. I really enjoy that. Again, I've got my Learn How to Play video up there, or LSV has done all these gameplay videos over at Channel Fireball. Nox has done his. I'll put all kinds of cool links in the video's description. But this is a real indicator, a real signal from Legend Story Studios that they are interested in Flesh and Blood, not just as a collectible, but as a game. Remember that name, Flesh and Blood, it's a weird kind of title, but it means that this is meant to be played in person, in Flesh and Blood. They've expressed a value in local game stores, and local game stores that I've spoken to have said to me that they're very easy to deal with, that they give a lot of incentives for them to carry their product, which is always nice to hear. But here we literally have Grand Prix-like events run by the company that ran Grand Prix. So it's just wild to hear that this is happening. But I am not just excited about this as a Flesh and Blood player. I'm also excited about this as a Magic the Gathering player, because if Flesh and Blood is going to be having Grand Prix-like events put on by none other than Channel Fireball, then what's to stop Wizards of the Coast from, hopefully, maybe even this year, putting on events like this for Magic the Gathering again? One thing we learned over the past year to year and a half is that it's not Magic without the Gathering. And when I see a small company, a new company like Legend Stories Studios that have an awesome game, if they can do this, surely Wizards of the Coast can and will and may already be making some kind of plans to do so. Remember, before the global pandemic, they had just introduced Command Fests, the redesigned Magic Fests, and as I recall, they were a huge hit. So I'm feeling very hopeful, very optimistic, and more than anything, very excited by this news. I actually got a non-zero amount of grief because I was very pessimistic and nervous during the pandemic about what coming out of it would look like. And I've been so happy lately, now that I'm double vaccinated, to be able to be getting games of Magic the Gathering, board games, Dungeons and Dragons, Flesh and Blood, all the stuff I used to play with my friends and at my local game store, getting that again, seeing my old friends again, getting to go on trips to play with friends new and old. It's been so exhilarating. And so even if I'm not going to play in the main event for this Flesh and Blood tournament, I'm probably going to attend. I want to go there, jam some games on the side maybe, see what's happening, or at the very least, just remember to turn it on when they stream it and have live coverage. I wonder who's going to be doing it. LSV has done all these cool gameplay videos for Flesh and Blood where you can watch him playing the game, one of the best Magic players in the world playing this game. I know Nox is also a really big fan and has done a lot of content about it. I don't know. You tell me, but I'm feeling happy and optimistic. I'm feeling really good. And I'm seeing this not just as an indicator for Flesh and Blood, but an indicator about where we, as people who love sitting down in person to play these great games, from Magic the Gathering to Pokemon to Flesh and Blood to I've been playing the Digimon game. It's fun and I like it. I just really feel good. And you'll let me know in the comments if I'm being overly optimistic, if I've just been locked up in here so long that I'm jumping at the chance to once again be amongst others, and if I should slow down. Is this too soon to be having events? Let me know in the comments below. Will I see you in Vegas or one of the other many locations that these Flesh and Blood tournaments are being held? Are you going for side event games, or do you want a shot at the Pro Tour? Either way, I hope very soon that you and I can jam some games.